This is Lenny Farley, Purdue University Extension Forester. Now let's ID that tree. In this edition of ID That Tree, we're going to introduce you to another native Indiana tree species that's in trouble, and that is white ash. White ash is one of several species of ash found in Indiana, typically on higher and drier sites than some of our other ash species. And it is, along with the other ash species, susceptible to the emerald ash borer, a Far Eastern Asian invasive insect species that's larvae penetrate underneath the bark and eat the cambium of these live trees, ultimately killing them. All our ashes have opposite leaf arrangement, and so we'll find buds and leaf scars directly opposite each other on the twigs this time of year, and a relatively large and squat terminal bud. Ashes have compound leaves on a straight leaf stem, somewhat reminiscent of hickory and walnut, typically 7 to 9 leaflets, so fewer than we typically find on walnut, and the leaflets tend to be about the same size as opposed to hickory, which typically has larger leaflets as we get toward the end of that compound leaf. As I mentioned, there are several species of ash here in Indiana. Green ash and white ash are pretty easily confused with each other, but one characteristic for white ash is a bud that descends down into the leaf scar, creating kind of a smiley face for that leaf scar. That's for white ash. On green ash, typically the bud sits on top of the leaf scar, and so the leaf scar looks like a shield. The bark on ash is typically a light gray, an interlacing network of ridges forming kind of a diamond shape. And the underbark, if we get a little bit of a damage point on the bark, tends to be a light tan in color. This species can look a little bit like black walnut, but black walnut underbark is very dark chocolate brown. As we mentioned, this species has been attacked by the invasive emerald ash borer, and unfortunately, most of our larger ashes look like this. Trees that have since been killed and are gradually falling apart on the landscape. And unfortunately, mostly what we find now is regeneration of small ash seedlings in the forest understory. So white ash, one of our trees in trouble here in Indiana from an invasive beetle.